Democrats in the House Oversight Committee are renewing their push to subpoena Jared Kushner over his private equity firm's shady dealings with Saudi Arabia. In fact, the dealings are so shady that even Republican Congressman James Comer questioned the ethics behind it. So let's get into the details here. Today, Democratic Congressman Jamie Raskin, a ranking member of the House Oversight Committee, sent a letter to Republican Chairman James Comer about Kushner and his work with Affinity Partners. Keep that company's name in mind. Now, Kushner founded the firm just after leaving the White House, thanks in large part to pretty hefty investments coming from the Saudi government and other Gulf nations. Now, he purportedly took $2 billion from a sovereign wealth fund chaired by Saudi Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman. And for the purposes of the story, I'll refer to him as MBS. Now, Kushner's firm structured those funds in such a way that it did not have to disclose the source of the funds. Now let's get to more details here. That wasn't the only thing that Trump and Kushner got out of their cozy relationship with MBS and Saudi Arabia. A year after his presidency, Trump's golf courses began hosting tournaments for the Saudi fund-backed Live Golf. Separately, the former president's family company, the Trump Organization, secured an agreement with a Saudi real estate company that plans to build a Trump hotel as part of a $4 billion golf resort in Oman. And Raskin wrote in a letter directly to Jared Kushner just back in February, your efforts to protect the crown prince may have allowed him to maintain his position at the top of the Saudi government and thus his ability to deliver significant financial benefits to you and your father-in-law after the end of the Trump administration. President Trump expressed an explicit awareness of the crown prince's debt when Secretary Pompeo embarked on a state visit to the Middle East to visit the crown prince. He wrote that President Trump told him, quote, "My Mike, go and have a good time. Tell him he owes us." And here's Jamie Raskin 6 months ago explaining even further why he felt that subpoenaing Kushner was an important thing to do.
The question for us is, what did Saudi Arabia get? Did it get protection for all the human rights abuses, for the war against Yemen, for the blockade against Qatar, and for specifically protection for the homicidal crown prince when he ordered the assassination, kidnapping, dismemberment of Jamal Khashoggi? We know that Jared Kushner got $2 billion out of it, a $25 million management fee every year, which is basically like an annuity on $1 billion. So that's a very serious business that raises profound problems about conflict of interest. And indeed, the Constitution and the Emoluments Clause, which says that nobody who's in federal government, a high-ranking White House official like Jared Kushner or the president, can take anything from a prince, a king, or a foreign state without the express permission of Congress. And Congress never authorized any of this.
I'm just gonna give you one other detail that is, in my opinion, pretty damning in this story. So a report from The Intercept during the Trump years found that MBS bragged about having Kushner in his pocket. Kushner was also deeply involved in a $110 billion weapons sale to Saudi Arabia back in 2017. I distinctly remember that era and that weapons sale. Cenk, what are your thoughts?
So that story from The Intercept is incredibly important to this story overall. So let me give you more details because they're damning. So The Intercept had three sources, so rock solid story. Jared Kushner used to be the most avid reader of the presidential daily briefings, although he really had no business reading those. There's no reason for, he had no official role that would allow him to read those. There was a presidential daily briefing about the Saudis within the government that were helping the US. About a week after that presidential daily briefing goes out, Jared Kushner gets on a plane to Saudi Arabia, meets with MBS, and then comes home. A week after that, MBS arrests all of his opponents, including the ones helping us. One of them gets tortured to death. And then MBS, on top of solidifying his power when he imprisoned all of those other guys, he also made them give him billions of dollars of their own wealth. So the $2 billion that he gave to Jared Kushner is just a small part of what he stole from the other Saudi royals that Kushner potentially turned into MBS. Look, if these things are true, Jared Kushner is the single most corrupt person I have ever seen in American government. He makes his father-in-law, Donald Trump, look like a Boy Scout in comparison. MBS, according to those sources, bragged to other government officials in other countries that he had Jared Kushner in his pocket. And so this is a massive corruption story. You want to talk about Hunter Biden? Hunter Biden is a pimple on an elephant's ass compared to this story.
Yeah.
Okay. So should they be investigating this? Hell yes. And thank you, Jamie Raskin, for being one of the only sensible people in Congress and putting a spotlight on this. We're talking about corruption of family members. Mm-hmm. Look, I don't know how much Trump benefited from all of this corruption. We know that the Saudis have the LIV golf tournament, and they then got a bunch of those tournaments to be in Trump golf properties, and that's his main source of income these days. And then the Saudis went crazy out of their way to buy the PGA, and they have now said those tournaments are also going to be played in the Trump properties. So Trump stands to make millions of dollars, but it's still nothing compared to the $2 billion bounty that Kushner get. Remember, it's a theoretical investment. He doesn't keep the $2 billion, but what he does is he makes 20%, this is the usual deal, and I believe it's his deal too, 20% off of any money he makes from those investments, and 2% per year just goes straight into his pocket. So on that alone, he's making tens of millions of dollars and potentially hundreds of millions of dollars because of this potential corrupt deal.
Well, Cenk, you're right to be concerned about the potential corruption here. As I mentioned earlier, I want to repeat again, you're not the only one. Democrats aren't the only ones. In fact, the chair of the House Oversight Committee, James Comer, is also concerned about this. So he said that the whole thing reeks of corruption so bad that even James Comer earlier this month said that Kushner crossed the line of ethics by accepting $2 billion from Saudi's sovereign wealth fund. And so Raskin decided to write to Comer and make his case for the subpoena. He wrote, "I am encouraged by your recent acknowledgement that what Kushner did crossed the line of ethics and your repeated assertions that our committee is investigating foreign nationals' attempts to target and coerce high-ranking US officials, family members by providing money or other benefits in exchange for certain actions." That's a reference to Hunter Biden, of course. And then he continues to write, "I urge you to pursue a serious and objective investigation by issuing a subpoena to Affinity and requiring the firm to comply with my February 15th, 2023 request for documents regarding its receipt of billions of dollars from Gulf monarchies shortly after Mr. Kushner left a senior White House position he used to reshape US foreign policy towards Saudi Arabia and the Middle East in Saudi Arabia's favor. A request you have thus far allowed Mr. Kushner to ignore and defy." And turns out that a GOP spokesperson for the Oversight Committee has already brushed off this request. I'll give you that statement. "Ranking Member Raskin's letter to Chairman Comer is nothing more than an attempt to distract from the mounting evidence of Joe Biden's involvement in his family's influence peddling schemes. I would love to see that evidence. Thus far, they have failed to provide a shred of that, but nonetheless, let me continue. If Ranking Member Raskin was truly concerned about ethics and government, then he would join Republicans in our investigation of the Biden's blatant corruption. However, Ranking Member Raskin is only concerned about playing Biden family defense lawyer." Look, I want to be clear. Like, by all means, continue your investigation into Hunter Biden, which is really their attempt to try to implicate Joe Biden. They have failed to do that. But like, to pretend as though both instances are similar, right? The Jared Kushner potential corruption with the Saudis versus the no evidence provided in regard to Joe Biden selling his influence to foreign actors. It's just ridiculous to compare the two. But you want to continue with that, in my opinion, sham investigation, have at it. But what's fair is fair. And what Kushner did, potentially did, I would even venture to say is more important because he wasn't just, you know, a family member of the president of the United States. He was working in the White House during the Trump administration.
Yeah, so last couple of things here. So why was Jared Kushner obsessed with the Middle Eastern countries? Part of the reason is because he made the most spectacularly wrong real estate investment in American history. He bought 666 Fifth Avenue for a couple of billion dollars at its height right before the 2008 crash. It was already a disastrous decision before the crash. After the crash, it was gonna sink the entire family fortune. It was just the dumbest move that anyone has ever made. And so he, since no one in America would touch it, he had to go abroad to try to get someone else to buy it. And he pressured the government of Qatar tremendously to buy it. And eventually the Qataris said no. And when they said no, he went to the Saudis. And after this visit that he had to MBS, the Saudis and UAE, who also got some benefits out of Kushner, then did a blockade of Qatar because they wouldn't do his corrupt real estate deal. I mean, that's among the factors that were involved. This guy is the worst. And so, and he 100% for his own personal benefit. And if you remember, there was a moment in Trump's administration when the national security community flipped out about Jared Kushner and revoked his national security
clearance. I remember that.
This is what that was about.
Oh.
Because those were our sources that he turned over to the bad guys. By the way, also turned it over to fundamentalist Muslim radicals who then tortured and executed some of our sources.
I mean, Trump is very concerned about those kinds of people, right?
So, I mean, look, guys, this is why party politics sucks.
Yes.
A lot of times the Democrats will defend people they shouldn't defend. Although the Democrats throw their own under the bus all the time too. What, remember Al Franken? I mean, the slightest infraction of in human history, and they made him get out of the Senate. But the Republicans, in a sense, the way that they protect each other, if it didn't involve crimes and corruption, etc., would be a little bit admirable. They circle the wagons all the time. They will always defend their own, right? But in the context of horrible criminality and national security, that is not when you circle the wagons. Why do you want the snake inside your wagon to begin with? So, and you know why, because they're in a desperate attempt to cover up for Trump. But this is disgusting and as un-American as it gets. So it's not our job to criminally convict Jared Kushner. But based on overwhelming evidence that is already in the public, there should at a minimum be an investigation.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.